condition this for 50-year-old nearly. Let's see some goals in action.
Let's have a look at the teams first of all that were involved in that historic encounter. Colchester first. Norman, let's tax your memory, shall we?
Well, it's not that good, but I can remember the lad, Cram, I think he came from West Brom, somewhere like that. I think he's got a famous uncle.
You've got a famous nephew, yeah, I think.
Famous nephew. He's the
Sorry,
but he's got somebody famous in the Garvey's the same. I think he came from Hull City. But the ones that I do remember are the forwards. Lewis, Brian Lewis, he had a big say in what happened on that day. And the lad up front who I was marking and Jack was, which Dave Simmons, a big, strong inside forward then. And then Ray Crawford, who really scored an awful lot of goals in his time at Ipswich, and he had several clubs. But he was the one that we were worried about, and as it turns out... Oh.
Yeah, Bobby, tell us about the Leeds side.
Well, it was one of the great Leeds sides. I mean, every one of them are famous for what they did in this particular era. Great midfield players, Johnny Giles, Paul Reaney, Terry Cooper at the back, strong as anything. Norman, obviously, my brother Jack win everything in the air. Mick Jones, Alan Clark, great goal scorers. Pete could score with, from any distance, yeah. Was a terrific shot. And Paul Madeley there again, a very, very consistent player throughout the Leeds era.
Remember, it's a fifth round tie. 16,000 were packed into the Lair Road on the 13th of February 1971. If you need rhyming, that was the year that the D became the P. Yes, we were introduced to decimal currency, and I've been confused ever since. We join the tie for the kick-off, and in the commentary position is David Coleman.
And the Leeds are playing with the wind behind them. Final check on the referee's watch and with the linesman. Jack Charlton ready to pump a high one straight away, being carried long, long way by the wind. That was Cram. Now Madeley for Leeds. Straight away, working the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper, M. Smith. And Simmons, the out jump by Hunter, but he was pushed. Takes a free kick to Colchester. Norman Hunter. Leeds will want to press home the advantage of this almost gale force win they've got in the first half. Taken by Brian Hall, hit by Lewis. Oh, that was well blocked. Crawford really got hold of that. Ray Crawford really hit it. But Bobby Cram with the throw. That is settled for Brian Lewis taking it. Hunter. Lewis. Cram. Jordan. Bates. Brian Hall for Colchester. It's Madeley, and Bates has been hurt, but Alan Clark going on. That will give the Leeds trainer, Les Cocker, the chance to come on. Jack Charlton's having a word to the referee, obviously objected to what had happened then. Obviously got rather a painful knock on the head.
What are we going to do? And they certainly got at you right from the start, didn't they, Norman?
Well, yes, I can remember I gave a free kick away. We'd set off in their half and I'd give a free kick away. And then from then, they put a lot of pressure on us. And you saw headers, all right. Big Jack was great in the air, great header of a ball. But they had Simmons and they had Crawford, and they were going to put the ball in there and they were going to play and pick up the pieces.
Cooper. Treacherous. And Ball beat them all, but normally they would have timed their jumping better. Brian Gibbs. Graham Smith with a goal kick for Colchester. Hunter. He's chances mainly. And trouble off the ball between Simmons and Hunter. And an open clash.
Norman, you're getting a bit of your own medicine there.
Well, I did, yeah. He was a big lad, Simmons, and rightly so. You know, if you get stuck into people, then you expect it back. But he, in the end, he has the last say because he gets the third goal.
And Bobby, I mean, they're really going to put that ball as often as they can right into that Leeds penalty area, aren't they? Really?
Yeah, that's
keep
right.
On thumping the wall at them.
You see, they would have expected to be humiliated. They're really underdogs. But the longer the game goes on and Leeds haven't done them any great damage, the more it just lifts their confidence and just gives them that little boost.
Lorimer with the throw. Cooper, Lorimer. Awkward. Clark! And that all went wrong for the defence because of the wind, and Clark was inches wide. Maidley penalised. Maidley claiming that Brian Lewis, number 7, made a back for him. Captain Bobby Cram to take the kick. Straker got the last, but he was lucky to get a second bite. He didn't make contact, but he was fouled. Gary Straker, on occasions, has made rather odd mistakes. But rated by Don Revie, one of the best keepers in the league, and certainly Leeds' defensive record from season to season supports that. There's Gilchrist. Cooper with the throw. Hunter looking for Sprake. Sprake to Hunter. Jones, policed by Garvey. Clark, Cooper, goal kick, number 3 Bobby Cram, the goalkeeper, Graham Smith, ball hanging back in the wind. Won by Maidley, this is Jones. Maidley again. A cram for Colchester. It's Giles, 10 minutes gone and no score. Carla. Smith. It wasn't much of a challenge by Laura, but the crowd didn't like it, but the referee waved it on. Paul. It's Lewis.
Well, a good save by Gary Sprake. I mean, he had a dodgy start, but that was a good one.
That was a great save. What a great move that was.
Yes.
You know, it wasn't low division football, that. Good play, played out, good 1-2.
And pace as well.
Pace, highest quality. Yeah. That was terrific, yeah. They were very pleased that they didn't score there, Leeds.
Is going to like these conditions. On top of all else, it's bitterly cold. Gary Sprake not wearing gloves. Clark. This is Hall. Simmons policed by Jack Charlton. Well, Charlton missed his tackle completely. And the ball ran very kindly for Leeds then, and in fact, the referee stopped play and penalised Charlton. This free kick could be awkward because any ball in the air is a real test. Kick being taken by Brian Lewis.
One down, Norman. What do you remember of that goal?
Well, I can remember Lewis taking it, and I remember my job was to mark Crawford, and as it was knocked in, Gary started to come for it. Mine, yours, and then he left it.
Here
and then
it
unfortunately,
is.
Then Crawford had got away from me and scored.
In slow motion. Oh. Oh, yes. Indecision.
Well, it was a bit, and if you see prior to that, the free kick that was given, the lad Simmons, every time Gary got the ball, Simmons was after him in the air and everything else. And Big Jack, who gave the free kick away there, just tried to have a little tap at him just to let him know that he wasn't supposed to do that.
Really controlled football. Hunter. Reaney. Levy and Les Crocker there will recognise that they've got an uphill problem because conditions are all against control. Crawford. Good play again. And Charlton. This is Cooper. Call for Colchester. And a foul by Bates. No, it's waved on. Looked to be a bit high, to say the least, but the referee had a good view of that. That's the strength of the wind, thrown well over the halfway line. Cooper for Leeds. One for Jones to fight for. Marr, number nine. Just to throw, and Leeds are not at all happy on this tiny pitch. It's very compact, there's very little room from the touchlines to the stands. They haven't been able to settle at all. Hooper. Turner. Gilchrist. Good ball. Gift. Crawford's there. Simmons. 2-0.
Ray Crawford was always going to be the problem, wasn't he?
Yeah, well, he was a goal scorer and he was looking for little half chances. Yeah. And he was brave. The ball came in from the right hand side of the field. A bit of a speculative thing, but nevertheless, it just caused a little bit of a indecision at the back. A blockage had fell down. Instinct as a striker is, where is it? And he just sees it there, swings his left foot, and just has the little look that it actually hits the goal.
2-0 down at that point, then you know you're up against it.
Well, you know you're up against it, but if you look at it, they deserve to be two
yes.
up. They're first to the ball, they're playing the better stuff. Yeah. All we are doing here at the moment is just hitting long balls, and they deserve to be where they are.
Destroying Leeds football. It's certainly not destroying Colchester. Indeed. Play being brought back, it's a free kick to Leeds, so the players don't know. Well, Colchester are full of aggression, and they're playing their football well, they're working out their moves, and the conditions just don't seem to have settled. control that bobbling ball.
Bobby, 2-0, and Leeds trying to come back, and maybe a bumpy pitch, or maybe first touch, or what? There.
Well, they're, like Norman says, they're just playing so well, and they're quite prepared to take chances, probably more chances than they would normally do in the league position that they're in. They know that if they don't take a few chances, they're not going to be good enough to win. But they are taking them, and it's working. I mean, Garvey, with his left foot there, would never in years have had a crack at goal from that distance with his left foot. You know, but
against the wind.
Against the wind, missed the post by 6 inches, you know. That would have been 3. I mean, it's just, this is really typical upset in the cup.
And certainly coaches are dishing out the medicine too, Norman.
Well, yes, they are. Well, it was their cup final, Dickie. They were up for this, weren't they?
Yes.
And we were probably the best team in the land, or one of the best teams at the land at the time, and they were not going to let us settle. They were not going to let us play. Yeah. And their tactics were dead right. Yeah.
Time played at half. Bates for lead. Jones. There's Gilchrist who got the decisive foot there. Lewis and a throw to Leeds. Lewis quite happy to waste time by taking the ball away. A Cooper with the throw. The whistle will go any moment, and there it is. And Leeds are trailing by 2-0. The goal scored by Ray Crawford after 18 and 24 minutes, 30 odd years of age. Really showed himself in this first half to be a very, very good player still.
Colchester lineup. There, Crawford. Ex-England.